Hello everyone, this is Ogai Azerbaijan and today we will get to know another band which was created in 2010 and comes all the way from Portugal, combining the universe of blues, soul and funk. The Black Mambo is one of the finalists in Festival da Canção and they believe that love is on their side.
Love is on the side.
Hello, Pedro.
Hello, hello.
And
nice
welcome.
To meet you. Thank you.
Pedro, before starting actual questions, can you please introduce yourself? Like, who is the Black Mamba?
So you said it all, I guess. It's a band, the soul, blues, funk, a little bit of rock and roll too. Band in Portugal. We're 11 years old, I guess. And we started at small clubs, bars, doing covers and versions of other artists. Then I was like, I started to think that it was better to move on, to give the next step and to record my own songs. So that's what we did late 2011. The first song came out late 2011 or early 2012. The first album, May 2012. And it was like, when the first album was released, it all happened so fast because like 2 months before that, we were playing small clubs and small bars in Lisbon. And right before the album came out, we performed at Rock in Rio, Lisbon. It's one of the biggest festivals in the world. And then we went to the United States to tour there. That's how it started. So ever since we played all over the world, Rock in Rio, Brazil, London. We've never been to Azerbaijan. After that, we started to grow up really fast. We sold out the biggest venues in Portugal, like the Coliseums, both in Lisbon and Porto. So everything went really cool. And we're honored to be a part of the Festival da Canção. It was not in our plans, I can admit.
Before actually creating the band, did you know each other?
I played with Miguel Casais in other projects long before the band started. PT, the bass player, is the guy that was part of my second band that I had, like high school band. And the others, I got to meet them along the road, you know. Only me and Miguel are the original members from the original band.
And who is your inspiration music-wise?
And we have plenty of them, but as a singer, I really dig the soul, R&B, old school, blues, rock and roll, old school kind of singers. We're more into old school music, but we love all the rock and roll in the late 60s, in the 70s. I don't like the sound of the 80s. I guess that's it. I guess it has rock and roll combined with Black American music.
And Pedro, as you mentioned, in 2012, you released your self-titled first album. And immediately after it, you reached number one in iTunes.
Yeah.
What was the magic?
I'm not sure. I guess there were two or three things that make it happen. First one, I guess, we didn't have back then like a soul blues, old school R&B band in Portugal doing the job the way we were doing back in the day. So it was like really surprising when we came out with the first song. I guess people were like blown away. It looks like it was a long time ago because music and pop music changed so much from 2010 to now. But we were living in like Amy Winehouse kind of era. So she brought back these old school vibes of the R&B old school. I guess there was an open door. People were like into it. I'm not sure if it would happen the same way if it were right now.
And after a successful release of your album, you also started your debut tour. You gave concerts in London, Philadelphia, Luanda, Madrid, and so on, as well as you participated in one of the biggest festivals in Rio de Janeiro in 2013, Rock in Rio. So as well as like other festivals. So my question is like, what experiences such festivals give to you, or how has attending such festivals helped you to grow as a band?
At the beginning, it's really important because most of the people there are not there for you. So they are there for the headliners, the Foo Fighters, the Bob Dylan. So, but they get to see you because of that. So, and it's a lot of people doing that at the same time. So it's really important to the growth. After that, it was like most of the people knew us. So we got promoted up in the slots. It gives you a lot of confidence, a lot of self-confidence to realize that you can put a big, big, big audience, like 50,000 people, 60,000 people singing your song and get thrilled with what you're doing. It's really important for you to realize that you're doing the right thing, that you're doing it right.
Actually, do you have any interesting story what happened to you in the festivals?
The first time we got the opportunity to be there at the main stage twice, Nós Alive. I guess it's the biggest in Portugal. The first time we performed at the main stage, we're talking about a lot of people, the PA system, the audio system, the speakers to the audience, they just turned off. I don't know what happened. Suddenly, all of a sudden, it shut down. But I didn't realize that happened. So I kept on playing and singing and jumping like a monkey, like for 10 minutes, I guess. And people were not listening anything. Because I didn't realize that was happening, because we still had the monitor sound. When the audience system came back in again, it was like, wow, a big explosion. So when we finished, people were crazy about the attitude, not stopping while the system was broke. It was fun because I didn't realize that it was broke.
And in 2014, you released your second album called Dirty Little Brothers.
The second album was the next step. It was when the most part of the Portuguese audience got to know us. Most of it was because of the song that we had with Aria. Won't you give us a try? And I say goodbye. Tell me, 'cause I wonder because she was really huge back in the day. And she started as a kind of Amy Winehouse, Duffy kind of thing. So she was really connected to the rhythm and blues old school scene. So we recorded Wonder Why. And that's our first hit, I guess, here. Then we have this song with Antonio Zambujo. Antonio Zambujo, I don't know if you know him, but it's one of the biggest names in Portugal around the world because of Fado. That happened because I had wrote this fado. That was my first fado that I ever write. And it was half Portuguese, half in English. So I invited him to sing the Portuguese part as a fado singer, and I would sing the English part. I've been thinking about you. Tenho pensado em ti. No rio que corre lava as tuas desgraças. For me, he's one of the best singers in the world, Antonio Zambujo. He's really, really... really good.
I wonder, like, can you please describe each of your three albums or how different they are to the previous ones?
They're all different because of different things. First album, you don't have money. You don't have the experience to deal with all the process behind recording an album. It's difficult. It's hard. So first album was recorded in like 1 week, 7 days, 6 days. I'm not sure. Now we mix it. Now we master it. And it's coming up. Okay. But it was really authentic, really genuine, you know. It was not overthinked, you know. So it was genuine because of that. Second album, I was almost living in the studio. So we had like 1 year recording the album. I really dig the album, but I think it's not as consistent as it could be. It's a bit of a mess, I guess, gender-wise. But I really dig it as well, and he has really cool songs that I'm really proud of. The third album, with the experience from the others, I guess it's the best. He had the time to be recorded properly and to be thanked and to be planned. And we were better musicians, better performers as well, because we evolved. I guess that's life, isn't it?
Definitely. Pedro, you are also writing your songs by yourself. How's writing lyrics or making music work for you?
It's a natural process, you know. I really love to sing in my own language. My solo career is totally sang in Portuguese. Every day I write, if it comes out in Portuguese, I use it in my solo project. If it comes out in English, I use it in the Black Mamba. If it doesn't fit any of these kind of vibes that we have in both projects, I give it to another people. So that's the way I work. I have a lot of songs that people don't know. But with all this lockdown kind of thing, I hope that most of the people get to know my repertoire, Ethan repertoire, really soon.
Actually, talking about this pandemic, how it affected you, like to your music career?
It's fucked up right now. We don't play live for a long time. Normally, we do 40 to 50 gigs a year. We were finishing a tour that we were doing on the winter before the first lockdown in March, almost a year ago. So we still toured a lot in the beginning of 2020. Then we locked down, and I guess we had like 6 or 8 shows instead of 50 or 40. But it was cool because we're touring so hard for the last 10 years that it was cool to slow it down a little, you know, to put things in place, to clear the mind a little bit, and to write and to go to songs that are unfinished. When you're touring all the time, you're always tired. You don't want to go to studio every day, 12 hours. So that's what I'm doing right now.
Let's then actually move to Festival da Canção. How did you decide that you want to be part of it?
It was a tough decision because I accepted first to be a songwriter. And then I had to choose if it would be me to perform the song or if I would pick someone else to do it. In Portugal, I guess we have this kind of resistance to go to Festival da Canção with an English song. People don't like it very much. But when it came to pick the song, I went to songs that I've written before. I was between one song that I have in Portuguese and this song, Now Love Is On My Side. Because those were the best songs that I had at the moment. The next step was like, okay, decide which song and to which perspectives would it bring to our careers, which doors would it open to me as a solo artist or the Black Mamba. Despite this always this English issue, we decided to go with the Black Mamba, Love Is On My Side, because as we're speaking now, you know, it gets a lot of attention from other countries. So as we want to go to other countries, play and tour a lot, we decided to give Love Is On My Side a chance. And people around the world are watching this right now. I'm sharing the love with us, saying the love, the song. That's gold for us.
What actually would it mean to you to win Festival da Canção and represent Portugal in Rotterdam?
It would be a great honor, man. It would be a dream in represent Portugal in if you go there and everyone counting on you. But I like that kind of responsibility, you know.
And since you are behind your own entry, Love Is On My Side, can you tell us what's the meaning behind the song?
I can tell you the story that inspired me to write the song. We were touring in Amsterdam, London, Cambridge, Amsterdam, right after our record, Mamba King, came out. We met this old lady in Amsterdam that told us her story. And her story was, that's her story. The song is about a story. So she came from Bulgaria or some country like that with a bag full of dreams and a lot of love in her heart, a lot of good things that she thought that were going to happen to her. So, but everything went the other way. Everything went wrong. She went to Amsterdam. She got addicted to drugs. She became a prostitute just to buy another shot. So everything went wrong. Everything went the other way that she planned. Life was really a bitch for her. But the inspiring thing was the hope that the message of her story had. She always felt that love has always been by her side after all that happened to her. That really inspired me. And when I came back home, I wrote this song, Love Is On My Side. Hopefully we get to Rotterdam. Hopefully she watched it and she realizes that's a story.
Pedro, I also guess you already listened to all the songs from Festival Back in Sal.
Not all of them.
Okay. The ones which you listen, what do you think, who can be a good competition to you? And if not your song, whom you would like to win as a competition?
I really like the Contramão, Felipe Melo and Sara Fons. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I really love that song. It reminds me a little bit of Mar pelos Dois. It's mm-hmm. It has this that kind of vibe. So I really like those kind of songs. It's my personal taste. I really like Caretos. It's not my personal taste. It's not the kind of music I listen. I have to admit that it's really well produced, really well written as well. I like the song Gira Sol. It was a shame that it was not through the final. Carolina is a friend of mine. She writes beautiful songs. This song that he brought to Festival da Canção is really cool, Por Triz. I love it. Neve is a really cool song. It's not my kind of song, but it's really well sang, really, really well produced and performed. There's a few more that I can't recall right now, but I guess it's getting better and better every year. The mm-hmm. level, it's
going
pushing up mm-hmm. every year. It came back, like people look at it in a special way right now. It's prestige kind of event, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
people want to be a part of it, so the level goes up.
And besides Festival de Canção, what plans do you have? Any new albums perhaps?
We're planning on doing like our own lockdown, but in the studio. Hopefully we're going to be out there performing in the summer, so we have till summer to do something. I'm writing a lot of stuff. I'm recording a lot of stuff because I'm at the studio right now.
Mm-hmm.
I can do a good tour. This is the piano, keyboards, parts. That's the drums, the main board, all the guitars and that stuff. So I'm here by myself recording and writing a lot of stuff. Mm-hmm. So hopefully I have a lot of material to come out really soon. But with the boys, we weren't able to be with each other like for 1 year. So now we're planning on testing ourselves, everybody, and lockdown like for a week or two and see what comes out.
And Pedro, if I can ask, play a little your song.
Left home when I was only sweet 16. Chase and play love in a bunch of broken dreams. Don't know how I thought I'd be cool. I could do anything. And somehow I end up here. I don't know why. I still believe. Love is on my side. Love is on my side. Love is on my side. Maybe not tonight. Maybe not tonight.
Oh my God. Thank you very, very much. Do you have any message for your fans?
People out there all over the world, if you're watching on March the 6th to the finals, I hope you're watching. If you want to, I guess, you're free to vote and support us. It would be really important. It'd mean the world for us, okay? So, I see you there.
Thank you, Pedro, for this interview. I really enjoyed to talk to you, and I hope you enjoyed this interview as well.
Yeah, I really dig it.
I wish you a very good luck in Festival da Canção, and who knows, perhaps you are the one for Portugal this year.
Thank you. I hope so. Let's see what happens.